We've been carrying everything, and I figured Eddie wouldn't see this coming. I have to be able to take some pain to dish out some more. Yeah, Eddie was Eddie, man. Always thinking, always a step ahead of me. I just knew what was coming. I just felt a little too confident, you know, and he took me out viciously. You know, at the end of the day, it felt like this was just a nice reminder that it wasn't just a match. You know what I mean? I mean, Eddie was trying to stop me that night as I was trying to stop him. He wanted to take it all away from me, and I could not slip on that fact. You know, that slingshot senton that Eddie always does, it's beautiful to see when you're not on the receiving end, but it sucked being on the other end of that senton. And seeing him taunt me, you know, it kind of boosted me up. It fueled me up to keep going during that match.
Thank you.
I felt during this match is I kept getting frustrated. You know, thinking that I was in control, when in an instant, you're trying to catch your breath while you're on the floor. Like I said, Eddie was Eddie, and he knew exactly how to mess with my head. You know, I just remember thinking, not like this. I couldn't lose my mask to Eddie like this. So I had to keep going. In the span of 3 seconds, I took one of Eddie's biggest moves, the Gory Special, and kicked out of it. But then I get a drop kick on the back of my head. I was starting to really wonder if I'd be able to win this thing, and was really getting desperate.
Thank you.
remember feeling out of place while I was sitting on the top turnbuckle in a tree of woe. But I managed to shake off what Eddie was about to hit me with next. I just remember everything in my body screaming, "Move now!" And I did move. I'm glad I listened to myself. Some of my top signature moves is flying over the top rope onto the floor. You know, and I felt like Eddie had an answer for everything. Not this time. Thank goodness. A move that has given me so many victories, the Rana. I remember hooking Eddie for a 1, 2, and he kicked out. I'm thinking to myself, what do I have to do to beat this guy? Incredible ring awareness. Respect.
Two! Thank you.
one of the most vicious moves that I've taken from other wrestlers. Eddie, being a master at this, the powerbomb. I just remember the ref screaming, one, two, and I said, here's the time to kick your shoulder up, and did everything I could to break the count. Again, I insist on this. Eddie had an answer for everything. I think that's just because of the styles. We were very similar in styles. But this move right here, the backbreaker, very special in Lucha Libre. Again, we go back to the famous powerbomb, which in this case, I was literally standing on the top rope. Eddie had me in a Splash Mountain move when the only thing I could think of at that point, hook him into a rana. That's exactly what I did. I remember taking him down, felt my knees bang against the mat, but I hooked that one leg, and then I just pushed my weight forward, and I just heard the one, two, three. It was over at that point. I have to admit, regaining the championship was one of the greatest feelings in the world. Pero el poder defender el honor de la máscara y el nombre de Misterio fue algo mucho más grande.